Welcome to our Thursday night prayer and intercession time. I'm going to ask that everyone go ahead and just stand. We're going to engage God tonight in asking specifically the theme of this next hour is going to be revival in the city, revival in the town, in the Bay Area. And I just want to encourage us that God hears our prayers, that not one prayer gets missed, and that there's power in unity. And so we're going to tear it up tonight. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your presence in this house. Father, we settle our hearts right now. We come this hour to pour out before you. Father, I'm asking that you would strengthen us as believers, that you would strengthen this church, and a spirit of revival would hit our hearts. Father, give us a hunger for lost people. Give us a hunger to share the gospel. Father, we ask that you would do a burning away of the flesh when it comes to fear and intimidation from us opening up our mouths, letting the world know who we are, lovers of you. Father, I'm asking even right now that you just cast off all depression, all despair, any yoke of heaviness that we might be carrying. For Father, we're going to go into this hour and we're going to pursue you and we're going to continue to ask for your will to be done, for your will to be done in this valley, for your will to be done in this church. Your will is that everyone who looks to the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life. And so, Father, we're proclaiming eternal life over this valley. Lord, would you do something in our hearts tonight? As right now, we welcome your presence. We welcome your presence. We welcome the beauty of who you are. Lord, would you draw us close to you with cords of love? Father, we thank you for your mercy and your grace. Embark tonight on our prayers, Father. I'm asking that you would answer them swiftly and with power and with might. So, Father, we dedicate this hour to you. Would you move in power in Jesus' name?
Presence, we honor your presence and holy. praying out of Acts 1, verse 7. He said to them, "It is not for you to know the times or dates the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in Judea and in Samaria and to the ends of the earth." Father God, we're here tonight. We're crying out for revival in this region, Lord. Father God, I pray that you would pour out revival. Pour out your spirit on your people in this church, Lord God. I pray that you would pour out your spirit on the people of Danville, Lord God, of San Ramon, of Oakland and San Leandro, Castro Valley, Lord God. God, I pray that you would open up the eyes of the people that have walked away from the faith, Lord God. I pray that you would heal the brokenhearted tonight, Lord God. One touch of you, Lord God, would heal them. Father God, I'm asking tonight that you would revive the hearts of every Christian that's grown cold, Lord God, or grown bitter. Father God, I pray that you would touch them with your Holy Spirit tonight, Lord God. That we cry out for our family members all throughout this region, Lord. That you pour out your spirit and that we see an awakening in this region like never before, Father God. That people would be so filled with the Holy Spirit when they go to work, they're not going to be able to shut their mouths talking about what Jesus Christ has done in their lives. When they go to school, they're not going to be able to shut their mouths and they're not going to be able to stop talking about what Jesus Christ has done in their lives. Father God, we're praying for revival tonight, God. We're asking that you would pour out your spirit on your people, pour out your spirit on this church and the leadership team here, God, and the worship team, Father God, and all the children. We cry out for revival in Jesus' name, Lord, and we receive it, God.
Thank you, God. living in thankfulness, that it would change the atmosphere when we say thank you, Jesus, for the way that you're moving in our city. We're acknowledging that he is moving, that he is responding to our prayers. So let's just lift up our song together tonight, because there's something powerful when the body of Christ comes together and sings and contends. So let's sing this. Thank you. I want to continue praying together for revival in Danville and in the Tri-Valley region out of Ephesians 3, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ which surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled up to all the fullness of God. God, tonight we lean upon your love for Danville. We lean upon your heart for the Tri-Valley area. God, we want to lock in with your heart tonight. God, when you look at Danville, God, your heart burns. Your heart is hungry for hearts to know you, for hearts to know that your love literally never ends from east to west. God, there's where it doesn't meet. God, your love continues and abounds still more and more. And we pray over Danville tonight that those here in this region, men, women, and children, would come to the knowledge that this is your love, that your love can literally never be too far from them. God, you are near to the brokenhearted. And we declare it over Danville tonight that you are the God who is willing to pour out your mercy. You are the God who is willing to pour out your power and your love in a deep measure. You are the God that sees. You are the God that knows. You are the God that is close to the brokenhearted and comforts those in need. And so, God, we cry out on behalf of Danville, who is in need of you. And we say, God, would you come with your power? Come with the knowledge of your love. Come with your blood that washes away every stain. We're calling on your presence tonight to come in a deeper measure, to come and lay across Danville, God, that your presence would be noticed, God, in a different way, God, from here tonight going forward. We just bring forth your presence and we welcome you into Danville. Come and have your way, because God, you are willing. Come and have your way in Jesus' name.
Spread your love over Danville.
Starting to rise. Come on. Oh, death is defeated. Oh, we are victorious. Cause you
sense the sweetness of the presence of the Holy Spirit tonight. The Bible says it's His kindness that leads to repentance. And I just sense that the Lord's wanted to pour out His kindness in this church and in our own lives. And right now would be a really good time to get right with the Lord. Under the umbrella of His kindness, not His wrath, it's not His anger, He's not mad, He's just wanting to release kindness. He's wanting to give you a taste of His kindness so that there can be a cleansing out of whatever needs to be cleansed out of your life, for revival to be released in our own hearts and our own lives, for that kindness then to spread to other people. The Bible says, obviously, God so loved the world. He so loved it. He so loved this region. He so loved our homes. He so loved Danville that He gave us His Son, that if we just believe in Him, we would receive eternal life. And I just sense that the Lord's wanting to renew a fresh encounter with Him tonight in His kindness. So right where you're at, just for that, as the music continues to play, anyone who's watching and us in this room, right now, just do some business with the Lord. We're going to keep it going. Spend the next 45, maybe 2 minutes, just soaking in His kindness, soaking in His love, soaking in His mercy, and just begin to do some renouncing. What are the things that you just need to cast at His feet and just turn away from in order for Him just to do a complete cleansing of your heart? Well, Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank You for this kindness. And Father, as we turn to You this evening, I'm just asking just for that kindness just to be enhanced even more from glory to glory, from strength to strength. Father, we thank You for this kindness. Just going to do some business with God just for the next couple minutes. Worship team continues to pray. I want you guys just to maybe partner up with somebody just for the next 5 minutes and go to town and asking the Lord to save some people that you know, some people that could really turn to the kindness of the Lord and experience salvation. I want us to take some time to pray for family members, maybe friends. Partner up. Just partner up with twos or maybe threes. And let's lift up some names before the Lord of those who need to experience a touch of His kindness and turn and experience salvation.
To love you like we love no other. Just let me see.